Hello, how are you doing today?
Hi, Madison. Good, how are you?
I'm so well, and I'm so excited to talk about your film because it was so incredibly powerful. And a lot of people, whether they have experienced trauma or not, must see this film, in my opinion, because it truly does give so much insight. And it also shows that while it might not happen to you, it definitely has happened to people that you're close to.
Yes. Oftentimes when we think of sex trafficking or human trafficking, we think that this is happening elsewhere, that it's happening in third world countries. And once you really begin to understand the problem, you begin to realize that it's happening everywhere throughout the States and it's happening closer than you think.
Yeah. And this is actually the second time that you went to go make a film about sex trafficking. And there's some powerful and heartbreaking stories in there. Why did you want to make another film?
So the first film was, the main focus was to talk more about the issue. What is sex trafficking? Trying to understand it firsthand and sharing that with our community and those that watch the film. So it was more educational, you can say. And after the first film, we knew that we needed to do more and that the first film was incomplete. A lot of people wanted to know more about the victims, more about those that survive human trafficking. And, you know, that was kind of a recurring question. What happens to them after? And that is exactly why we decided to do Surviving Sex Trafficking. Is this film dives deep into the stories of survivors of sex trafficking. What is their journey post-trafficking? Because we think that, okay, let's go out there, let's go and rescue the victims. And, you know, we think that, okay, once they're rescued, that's it. But now they have to deal with all the trauma. They have to deal with the consequences of what they've gone through. And that's actually when their journey really begins. And that's the healing journey. And that's what we wanted to capture. Why? Because we want to make people aware of their trauma. We want people to understand what they go through because we want to help them. We want to inspire people to do more for the victims of sex trafficking.
Absolutely. I mean, I know that I was struck when I heard that there's 45 million sex trafficking victims worldwide, but only 1% was lucky enough to manage to escape. Do you personally believe, after all the stories that you heard in prepping and making this film, that people can ever truly heal from the trauma that they experienced?
You know, each person is different. There is no say in, you know, is this something that everybody can experience a full, complete healing? I cannot answer that because it's up to the individual of how much, you know, they're able to work on themselves, how much therapy they receive, how much help and all of these things. Is it possible for a person to completely heal from trauma and from past events? I 100% believe it is possible. I myself have healed from trauma as well as the director of the film Surviving Sex Trafficking. We were both victims of child sexual abuse, and we have both worked tremendously to overcome all of that pain that comes with it. And so, yes, we strongly believe that it is possible. But of course, you know, you cannot assume that everybody can do it because many people have gone through just too much. And, you know, and that's how much more help they will need to achieve that healing possibility.
Well, I first want to say that I'm so sorry that you and your co-producer both had to experience that in your lifetime. And I'm so happy to see that you are both strong enough to make it here today to be talking with me right now. What did you find was the biggest struggle amongst other survivors moving on to their next chapter?
You know, now they have to, you know, work on themselves and work on forgiveness, right? It's easy to, again, come out and being rescued. And like you said, only 1% of them manage to come back home safely. And out of that 1%, you know, it's very difficult to move on. And now they have to kind of deal with everything that they are still holding on to and caring from the experience. And it's not so much that they're afraid of their trafficker or the people that hurt them. It's more about what they have to deal with internally. That is the main struggle.
And then what about externally?
Externally, well, you know, a lot of them don't have anything. They come back home with zero. They don't have a home. They don't have a resume, you know, with a lot of experience to get a good job and to take care of themselves. So financially speaking, you know, they're struggling. They're struggling to be fully independent if they have children. So now they have to take care of them as well. So in the physical aspect, you know, there is medical conditions that they have to deal with. A lot of them have true damage in their brain, you know, from the trauma. And now that is another physical consequence that they have to deal with as well.
It's so heartbreaking. How difficult was it to find these victims and get them to be able to share their stories on camera?
You know, we were just so lucky to find these amazing, beautiful women that became part of the film. It all started with social media, putting a post and saying, are there any survivors that wish to be a part of our film? We want to feature stories about it. And one of them, Angie, who's in the film, immediately she reached out to us and she said, I watched your first film, Stopping Traffic. I was so impressed with the work you've done so far. And I want to be a part of this second film. And she said, you know, I live in Dallas. If you happen to be near Dallas one day, I would love to be interviewed for it. And we live outside of Dallas. And so it was just instant. She came out to our center and we met and we talked, and it was just instant that we, you know, built that kind of trust and relationship with her. And that is the thing, is that, you know, you have to be very respectful of their story, of their journey, and they need to trust you. And if they know that you have a pure intention, which I think they do, they know that, we're both the co-producers, we're both nuns or monks. And so our intention is always to help people. Our intention is to just share respectfully their stories. And I think they were able to tell that, and they opened up and they were able to share their stories. So it was through social media. And then we also did a trip around the world where we met some of the international survivors that we feature in the film. So going around to a few countries and meeting them and connecting with them and building that, again, trust and relationship with them. And that's how they were selected.
Yeah, this film really, truly is beautiful, and it holds so much power and truth behind it. And I don't want to take away from the victim's stories by asking this question, but a lot of times in Hollywood, things can get lost amongst the big A-list names. And what's beautiful is that three huge big A-listers, Alyssa Milano, Jeannie May, and Jeezy, all wanted to give you their platform by executive producing this film so that it can reach bigger and bigger audiences. What did that mean to you?
You know, in this journey of filmmaking and making these films specifically about sex trafficking, we have faced a lot of darkness because it's a very difficult subject. There is a lot of darkness to see and hear about when you start digging into this issue. At the same time, though, it's been beautiful because we have come across and found beautiful, amazing people out there trying to make a difference, trying to fight for the victims, trying to help survivors. And that's what they represent. Alyssa, Jeannie Mai, and GC, you know, they have their platforms. Obviously, they're very well known. And the fact that they wanted to lend their voice and their platform to help us, to help the cause, to make a difference, it speaks highly of them, you know, what they are intending to do, which is really to help. And they, all three of them, volunteer everything. It's so it's a beautiful collaboration that we have with them. And we're very honored for them to be a part of this project.
I love that so much. Well, thank you so much for your time today, and congratulations on making it to Santa Fe Film Festival. I'm so excited to see you guys premiere it at the
Thank you. Festival. Thank you so much. It is an honor to be a part of it. Thank you for your time.
Absolutely. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.